This is Unit 1, Lecture 1, and let's first find out what topics we are going to cover in Unit 1, Lecture 1. We will cover Unit 1 in two different lectures. In this very first lecture, we are going to talk about topics like enzyme catalysis and inhibition, where we talk about the mechanism of enzyme catalysis, how enzymes work, and also different types of enzyme-mediated inhibition. Then we'll talk about carbohydrate biochemistry, that is the structure of monosaccharide, disaccharide and polysaccharides, and few examples. We'll also talk about protein biochemistry, especially the structure of different types of protein, including the globular protein as well as the fibrous proteins. We'll also talk about example of one globular and one fibrous protein, hemoglobin and myoglobin, and particularly we'll be talking about the oxygen saturation curve of hemoglobin. The numbers written after every single topic name is the total number of approximate questions you will get from the topic in CSIRNet exam based on the study that I have done for the last 10 CSIRNet question papers.
We've talked about enzyme kinetics. Okay, we know about enzyme kinetics. We've discussed about the enzyme regulation and a part of, you know, the enzyme's inhibition. Now, the more we contact and talk about the carbohydrate metabolism or any other metabolism topics, we'll more understand about the regulation of different enzymes, how they work, different examples of enzymes and all. Now, at this point, we intend to talk about the macromolecules of biology. And macromolecules like carbohydrates, proteins, okay, lipids, these are the macromolecules. You know, in CSIRNet perspective, particularly this unit 1 is very, very important. They ask many questions from this unit 1. They always ask that. But in unit 1, they ask very few questions directly from this macromolecule side. They mostly ask questions related to, you know, modifications, related to different sort of mathematical problems, analytical issues, techniques and stuff like that. But still, you need to know a little bit about these macromolecules, like especially carbohydrate, because there are few more important topics to be covered. So the first thing that we want to talk about here is the disaccharides. You know, we all know about monosaccharides. You know, the carbohydrates can be classified into monosaccharides, disaccharides, polysaccharides. So we know that this monosaccharides like glucose, galactose, fructose, okay. So these are the monosaccharides. Now, these monosaccharides are joined together. Two such monosaccharides joined together is known as a disaccharide. Now, the important thing is that those disaccharides are very common form of sugar that is sometimes readily available. For example, sucrose is a readily available variety of the sugar, which is composed of glucose and fructose linked to one another. And I found out that CSIRNet tend to ask more questions from these disaccharide combinations. That means which monosaccharides are linked together to form this kind of disaccharide. So you can see lactose is composed of galactose and glucose. Maltose is composed of glucose and glucose linking together. Now when you look at the structures of sugar here, it's the ring structure that are drawn. Now one more thing that you need to understand is this connection between glucose, fructose and glucose, glucose in maltose are exactly the same. But the pattern of how two monomers are linked in lactose is different. Why? We can see this difference. You can look at this picture very clearly that the sucrose formation depends on adding fructose as well as the glucose. So you can see glucose and fructose link with one another with the help of beta 1-2 link. Means, you know, this sugar glucose is alpha and this sugar fructose is beta, and they're linked between 1 and 2. That means the number of carbon they're linked with is visible here, 1 with 2, okay? So whenever we write this disaccharide form and the bonding, we write like alpha D glucopyranosyl 1 to beta D fructofuranose. So you can see pyranose and furanose, there are two things. You know, pyranose, we have the 6 separate ring structure. Furanose, you can see this 5 carbon ring structure like that. Now, the second thing here, lactose, you can see, it's different, okay? It's beta 1-4. See, this is alpha 1-2, beta 1-4. And this link of beta 1-4, you know, beta D galactopyranosyl lactose, 1-4 alpha D glucopyranose. So a galactose with a glucose linked with 1,4 carbon link. In case of maltose, there are two glucose linked together with the help of 1,4, okay, alpha 1,4 linkage. So this was alpha 1,2, this is beta 1,4, this is alpha 1,4 link. And due to this kind of linkage, there are different kinds of sugar that are originated. So based on this idea, we can, you know, sometimes classify sugars as reducing and non-reducing sugar. So what do we say? A reducing sugar is any sugar that is capable of acting as a reducing agent because it has a free aldehyde or a free ketone group. Okay, so sucrose, for example, is a non-reducing sugar, while lactose and maltose both are examples of reducing sugar. Generally, you'll find most of these reducing sugars as disaccharides. Disaccharides mostly are kind of reducing. There are a few examples where you find out disaccharides, they are not reducing. Example for such, sucrose. Now, this is just something that you can remember, you know, because they can ask you group B questions from there with the linkage between the monomers, what kind of monomers are linked to form the dimers and stuff. But apart from that, we need to understand ideas about isomers, epimers, anomers, and all these things. So isomers, for example, compounds that have same chemical formula are known as isomers, like glucose, galactose, fructose, and mannose. These are isomers of one another. And isomers means same chemical formula. So in this case, all of them, glucose, galactose, fructose, mannose, they have the same chemical formula of C6H12O6, okay? C6H12O6 is the formula. So you can simply write it as C1H2O1. That's the formula. And bracket, you have N. So multiply it with 6, you'll get this result. So all of these glucose, galactose, fructose, mannose, they all share the same formula. But epimers are two isomers that differ in configuration around one specific carbon atom, okay? So, and that atom other than the carbon atom of the carbonyl group called the epimers. You can see glucose and galactose are epimers, glucose and mannose are epimers. Now, glucose and galactose are epimers in the carbon number 4, while glucose and mannose epimers in carbon number 2. So what I mean, let me show you that example. In this picture, we have the glucose, galactose, and mannose, all of this. The thing is, these epimers, they always share the same chemical formula because they are isomers of one another. This is the primary thing. There are isomers, but there's a difference that these two isomers differ in the configuration around one specific carbon. So if you look at glucose and galactose, you can see exactly same kind of formula that we can see. The difference that we can find out is in carbon number 4. Yeah, so this is the carbon number 4. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. The carbon number 4 in galactose is different than the carbon number 4 in glucose. And that's why we have differences in terms of glucose and galactose. So we can say galactose is the epimer of glucose as carbon number 4. Now if you look at this picture, you can see that carbon number 2 is also different, you know, they are not exactly the same. But we will not take that as an epimer here because, again, read the definition. Two isomers differ in configuration around one specific carbon atom other than the carbon atom of carbonyl group. So this is the carbon atom of the carbonyl group, okay? So that's why we will not take that as an account. You can see, clearly see the difference here. Now, second one is between glucose and mannose. If you look at glucose and mannose, actually this picture is also not correct way of representation of galactose. But you can see the glucose and mannose, you can see all of the arrangement are the same except for the carbon number 2. Okay. In carbon number 2, in this case OH in the left hand side, in case of mannose OH in the right hand side.